Okay.
Okay, it's recording now, so let me share my screen. Is it sharing? Oh, wait.
Not yet.
Okay.
How about now? You can see it. Yeah.
Much okay. Better. All righty. So, hi, everybody. Welcome to the Jenkins Advocacy and Outreach SIG. Today is January 12th, and on the agenda, I have some. We're going to go over some action items. CDF, their year in review. Go over some events. So FOSDEM, Scale, CDCon, DevOps World. And lastly, we'll save the last part of this meeting for GSOC planning discussions. Does that sound good? And is there anything else that we should add?
Don't forget the first point of the agenda.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. Okay, then. So important part, Happy New Year, Happy 2023. Wishing everybody good health, yeah, peace, and happiness.
Thank you, Jenkins. Sending the same to the people listening.
Thank you. Let me enlarge this a little bit. How about here? Okay.
Now I can read it. Yeah.
Oh, good.
Thank you.
Good, good. So action items. So I've created and communicated out the planning document for FOSDEM. Thank you, Bruno, for adding that.
You're welcome.
And so Jean-Marc, if you're planning, I know you're planning to attend. So
I will be there.
Whenever you're ready, please feel free to add your name to it.
Yep.
And then Jenkins 2022 recap. That is going to be published pretty soon, right, Bruno?
I think maybe today or later today or maybe tomorrow, hopefully.
Okay.
That's quite an adventure. I never imagined it would take so much time and back and forth between people, but that will be a jewel, I think, this recap.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, it's a big document, so... You know, we just need a lot of tweaking, but which is good, which is fine. We're getting there.
It means it's a rich report with a lot of things.
For sure. And I think we all should be proud of what has been accomplished. And Mark.
And a little ashamed that we didn't write it sooner. Sorry about that. The Mark Waite shame factor there. Bruno, you did a great job creating that thing, and here we are now revising it in massive ways. We should have written it first, so you could have had it easier, but hey.
Yeah, I just created the canvas, and then everybody put something, and it will be, you know, we were talking about pizza earlier, and this will be a fantastic recipe of pizza, I guess, with all the different ingredients which are in.
Yeah, for sure. Okay, so the next topic is CDF year in review blog post. They have initiated their 2022 year in review post. So basically, it's an update. They ask for three bullet updates from each of the projects under CDF, and they want to highlight what we did in 2022. So I submitted my six bullets, and yes, I don't know how to read numbers, but that's okay. I apologize for it, but I'm just keeping with six.
So the ordering, if they demand three, I propose. Oh, go ahead. I'm sorry. When we get to that, you continue. I should stop interrupting.
Okay. So I provided, highlights to the modernization of the UI UX. The modernization of the platform, our Jenkins election. And our involvement in the projects like She Code Africa, GSOC, Hacktoberfest. And I also included our pull request numbers, how many pull requests, just to give some little data. And the number of new contributors for Hacktoberfest. And then I also included a link to our blog post, just in case, you know, somebody wants the full story.
Yeah. Yeah, I just would change the order slightly. I think Jenkins elections was lower on the interest level for others, and outreach efforts, She Code Africa, GSOC, and Hacktoberfest are very high, right? Because CDF is about building communities and about fostering community. And those are a good example of successful efforts to build and create community and to bring people in who may not have who were not previously involved.
Okay. So then would you say that would be like right below the modernization?
I'd put it as modernize the UI, number one, absolutely. Mm-hmm. Modernize the platform, absolutely, number two. And then advocacy was number three. Then the other things in the six in the list is very fair. And I think we are the 800-pound gorilla in the CDF. Therefore, it's perfectly okay that we offer six and they say, no, you have to limit it to three.
Right.
I just wanted to be sure we get the top, the three that at least, now I'm open to John Mark and Bruno, do you have a different opinion in terms of priorities?
No, I second your ranking. Your ranking, the UX improvement is a very big win, as well as on the platform.
Right.
And well, we can also be proud of the work done on the outreach and advocacy action, GSOC, She Code Africa, and Hacktoberfest, these kind of events. So I second your choice. Is that the right word to say?
It is. Yeah, yes. You said it. You sounded very American. Well done.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
I'm not sure you consider that a compliment, but you sounded very.
No way. But learning.
Okay. Great. Thank you for that. I have time to get that fixed, so before they publish it, so
I'll get that just done. I think six was, I think you were right to give them six, right? We are the largest, and we have the most stories to tell because we're the largest. So they should consider giving Jenkins more space just because there's a bigger story to tell and a bigger community.
Yeah.
Other communities are still growing. They're nurturing them. They're developing them. Tecton is huge, right? Not as big as Jenkins, but it's huge. But there are plenty of small communities that they're nurturing. That Persia is a small one that they're nurturing and growing, and it's growing rapidly. That's great.
Yeah. Well, and they didn't say anything that, you know, hey, you gave me too much, so I'm just going to leave it alone.
Great. Yeah, they didn't come back to you saying, do you not know how to read, or is it a failure to count?
Yeah. So I think we're good. Also, I'll update accordingly on the priority of our list. Okay, moving on. For events, we have that's coming up. That's FOSDEM and SCALE. So FOSDEM is coming up in a couple of weeks. So I have created, like I mentioned earlier, the planning doc for it. The only thing that I still need, which I discussed with Jean-Marc yesterday, is that I need guidance on where do we think we want to have the Jenkins and Friends dinner and on what day. Previously, it's, you know, we have our usual location in evening, Friday evening. But I think Jean-Marc mentioned that there might be something better outside of the square that might be easier for people to get to. So Jean-Marc will talk to Damien and then we'll get that filled out.
Yeah. Yes. For the date, we will keep the Saturday night.
Saturday, yeah, so, or Friday?
Saturday.
Oh, Saturday. Okay.
Yes. Because Friday, I fear that a lot of people are still traveling and will come late. Now, we should discuss it, but at least I know the couple of colleagues. So my personal vote is to organize it Saturday, knowing that Bruno and I will have a conflict there. But
So I just talked to Damien about it earlier today. And so that's perfect, John Mark, that you and Damien are coordinating. And I think you own, I propose that the two of you own that one. You find the best time for it and just notify people so that we encourage others to who are at FOSDEM to join.
Yeah. Okay, I have a one-to-one with Damien tomorrow morning. So I'll raise that point with him, and that we take that on time so that Elissa is also able to include that information in the general information about FOSDEM, and also to publish that.
Thank you, Jean-Marc. And then I also put it here that you and possibly Bruno will be attending the GSOC gathering at FOSDEM. I was going through their website and I couldn't find the link to that. I didn't know that there was a discussion on it.
It's a mail. It's a mail.
That's what I thought.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's on the main GSOC list.
Okay. Then I will gather information and update it here.
Yeah. So we'll hold. So two things is I definitely want to network with the GSOC crowd that will be present at FOSDEM.
Mm-hmm.
I think that the Google people will be wearing their pennant, the GSOC flag, and so, well, I'll wear my captain's hat, so normally I should also be recognizable. They will not have a booth during it, but I will try to connect with as many people as we can and attend their event there. We might also, and I strongly promote the idea, do some talks or a bird of a feather related to GSOC at Jenkins GSOC at Jenkins. Our experience with it, answering questions to mentors or participants, and also sharing advice, experience with other organizations that want to participate to GSOC. So we'll see how that works. Best practices. Besides all the other communication, networking, and things that we'll do.
Yes. Okay. And then I know Bruno has a birds of a feather on the table as well. So thank you for adding that to the document. So yeah, we'll just refer to that.
Yeah, I mean, need not to forget to put it on the FOSDEM document. Yeah.
Moving on. Are we good with FOSDEM?
Yep.
Okay. So scale 20X, that's in March 2023. We do have a booth. I have not started planning because the event is later in March. So I will start planning in February. I got other things that's brewing at the moment. So, and then CDCon, that is going to be in May. In Vancouver, Canada, the CFP is currently open and they will close on February 10th. I am on their review committee. So if you are interested in speaking, I know Mark is going to be making submissions. Make your submission on time. And then they are accepting early submissions. So they're hoping to publish the agenda probably end of January. So they may have early submission is also available until January 17th, if I'm not mistaken.
I need to have a chat with you about with Mark, with you about that.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Okay. Any questions, comments?
Topic was CDCon.
CDCon.
Yes. Yeah. So I'm assuming that well, yeah, let's talk separately about it, John Mark, because I suspect international travel right now. Yeah, let's talk
separately. It's so, I fear it's not worth the hassle to propose a talk there.
Yeah.
But who knows? I'll talk to you offline.
Okay. And then DevOps World. So the CFP committee is forming for the entire conference. We're scheduled to be meeting next week. I am responsible for the Jenkins/community track. I don't know how many track they're giving us this year. So usually it's two tracks. So, well, it really depends on how many days that they're going to do this. So they're still shopping for the location and the date. We'll find out more soon, but I will be reaching out to the community to solicit for volunteers to join me in a subcommittee. What that will entail is basically reviewing the submissions for Jenkins/community. Grading the submission, scoring it, pick and choose, lay out the lay of the land for the conference for our tracks. So that is forthcoming. Okay. Anything else? Any that we need to cover for DevOps? So any questions I can answer? We're good? Okay. Nope. Okay, so John Mark, we are good in time, so.
Yes, because we have a meeting on that subject after this one.
Yeah.
So a quick summary where we're standing. So we have met people that stepped forward to be mentors. Some we know, others that we don't know. So we'll have to get to know each other. There will be activity to present the work of mentor and the responsibilities of a mentors, and to be sure that we are all aligned with that, giving the tools to get prepared and explain that. So mentorship, it starts to shape well. Project ideas, we have a sufficient number to start. We're still looking for other project ideas. I hear project ideas brewing, but the more we have, the better the students, contributors, will have chance to find something that fits their interest. So related to the first point, we'll organize a mentor roundup alignment orientation webinar on January 19th. There's a proposal. We're going to settle that during the org admin meeting just after that. We also plan to do some, not publicity, but to share the news and explain regularly where we're standing. And now is a good opportunity to write a blog post where we are standing right now, and so that we keep the people's interest. So I think the next steps, we'll confirm them during the org admin meeting there. So already planned, just to be confirmed, is the work on mentors. Work that's planned, and Alyssa is actively working on that, to be sure, is application as a mentoring org. So this is an important milestone. As soon as the application is confirmed, we will have the kickoff meeting. And so we're going to schedule that already now. So there, Lisa is helping me by highlighting the information. So we're going to announce that beginning of February on time, and so that we get everybody aligned and present there. And we will then start the office hour mechanism. So weekly meetings to answer questions and clarify doubts, and helping students, contributors to build a strong application. So this is the planning. We'll discuss during the org admin meeting if we should do the kickoff before we know that we're accepted. I can't. There's still some doubts or bolts that need to be tightened on this tentative planning here. We're making progress. We're good. We're in a planning. No red light or red flag up to now. So we're good on that. Bruno or Alyssa, is there something I missed or should clarify?
It's fine for me.
Yeah, I think it sounds good for me as well. We have, if there's anything, I mean, we have this document that is available that we're using as our guidance for planning.
Yeah.
So we just, there's much to be done here, the project idea, but I think we can get this finalized by the time that they publish the accepted mentoring orgs.
Right. Yeah. So we need to have a good lineup so that our application is strong. But there's also some incertitudes or some unknowns on where is the focus or interest from the applicants going to be.
Mm-hmm.
So we need to.
Yes.
So we'll more details on the next outreach SIG meeting. So because we have the meeting to fine tune that just after this one.
Yeah. Okay. We're good. Let me pause the recording.